It's AumSum time!
Why are vitamins important?
No, just vanilla ice cream is important.
Oh, AumSum. Vitamins are micronutrients which help perform important functions in our body. The most essential vitamins needed by our body are vitamin A, C, D, E, K, and a group of B-complex vitamins. Vitamin A is required to make a pigment called rhodopsin in our eyes. Rhodopsin helps us to see in low light conditions. Thus, without vitamin A, rhodopsin won't be produced, causing night blindness. Vitamins C and E are antioxidants. Unstable free radicals damage our cells' DNA, leading to illness or cancer. Vitamins C and E neutralize the free radicals, preventing cell damage. Vitamin D helps our body absorb calcium to build strong bones. Thus, lack of vitamin D can lead to a condition called rickets, which is characterized by weak, soft bones. During an injury, vitamin K helps the blood clot, thus preventing excessive bleeding. Lastly, B-complex vitamins are essential for a healthy functioning of our brain and nervous system. Why are some people allergic?
Because they didn't take my autograph.
No. People can be allergic to a wide range of things. Some of the most common ones include milk, peanuts, pollen, shellfish, etc. An allergy occurs when our immune system mistakenly identifies a normal, innocuous substance as a harmful intruder. Hence, it produces antibodies to kill the intruder and, in the process, gives rise to itching, runny nose, watery eyes, etc., thus causing an allergy. Now, according to hygiene hypothesis, allergies are caused due to clean environments. During childhood, exposure to germs allows our immune system to identify harmful substances. However, if children are kept in extremely clean environments and not exposed to germs at all, then their immune system fails to develop properly and instead starts attacking harmless substances, thus causing an allergy. For example, if such a person inhales some harmless pollen, his nose starts creating extra mucus to trap the pollen, making his nose run and thus causing an allergy. Why are some people lazy? 'Cause sloths kiss them. Nah. Laziness is disinclination to activity despite having the ability to do it. Now, there can be various causes of laziness. First is procrastination. It is the act of delaying or postponing something. At first, we might postpone small tasks. But eventually, prolonged procrastination can restrict all our actions, making us lazy.
Hello.
Second is distraction. In modern life, distractions like video games, cell phones, etc. have made children linger at one place, restraining their physical activity and thus making us lazy. Third is couch potato gene. When we complete a task, a neurotransmitter called dopamine is released, which gives us pleasure and makes us feel good. But due to the presence of this couch potato gene in some people, the ability of dopamine is restricted, resulting in less motivation to get up, thus making us a couch potato. Why are we afraid of the dark?
I'm so cool. I'm not afraid.
Some experts say humans have developed this fear due to evolution. In prehistoric times, our ancestors were at high risk of being attacked by predators or enemies when in dark. Hence, through evolution, the tendency to fear darkness developed. Also, in the dark, as we cannot see properly, it creates anxiety, making us imagine the worst possible outcomes. So, it is not the darkness itself that we find frightening. It is what or who lurks in that darkness. Also, if we observe other people getting afraid, or if we are told to be afraid about something, we immediately accept those things as scary. So, whether it is our parents warning us about the dark, or a horror movie showing a ghost appear in the dark, our brain latches onto it and starts getting afraid of the darkness. Why are tears salty?
Cause our eyes forgot to add sugar to them.
Ugh, just listen. There's no way that our tears cannot be salty because salt, that is, sodium chloride, is very essential for various bodily functions. Huh? Sodium in salt conducts nerve impulses, helps all the muscles to contract, etc. Chloride is an essential part of our stomach acid. According to research, there's about half a pound of salt in our bodies. Now, if we have so much salt, it makes sense that our bodily fluids, including sweat, blood, and tears, naturally have some salt in them. Besides this, it would take a lot of cellular energy to make sure that our tears were 100% pure water. Moreover, as some tears are continuously produced to lubricate our eyes, it is believed that salt in those tears inhibits the growth of bacteria, thus preventing infections.